this is Brig. I'm going to do a quick review of the wine glasses from Chris Fremont. He sent me four of them. I have two here. I have the Liberté. I guess that's how he pronounces it. This is the 1855. Over here is a glass that probably lots of people recognize. And this is a machined Gabriel glass. So the first thing that I noticed when I looked at these is, for me, is the base is very large. So if I put the Gabriel glass up next to it, you can see the, it's about a maybe a quarter of an inch bigger diameter. So the base is bigger, which is great for me. As I mentioned before, I'm really good at putting things on forks and on the edge of plates. So this is super sturdy. The other thing is it's a great plate handle if you're holding it like this versus, let's say, you've got the Gabriel glass and I've got big bear paws, so I've barely got my fingers on this one. So it's great for holding like that if you hold your wine glasses like that, or if you're me, I'll bear palm. The other thing is that the rim is much more narrow on these, so you can actually fit the glass, the Grasso glass inside of the Gabriel, and probably fit the whole glass. There, look at that, inside of there. So I'm gonna do a taste. I've got a 1994 Vincent Pinot Noir. This is the Armstrong Vineyard. Also a wine berserker, by the way, so highly recommend Vincent's wines. I think I won this one in an auction, but I've also bought. So basically a pop of pour. I just opened this up a little while ago, maybe 15 minutes ago. So let's do this. I'm gonna start with the classic here. This is the classic Pinot glass. Now, I have a few of these. I love these glasses. The problem is that they're enormous. And if you're ever at a tasting and you have more than a few wines in front of you, you end up taking up all the space in the table. But stick my nose in there. I do love that glass. Now let's try this guy. This has a lot lighter feel to it. This is a very heavy glass. The stem's very heavy. This is a much narrower stem. And again, it's got the big foot on it. Let's give it a good swirl. Much more intense nose here, probably because the narrowness here. So I guess that was probably the intent on that. Nice, let's taste. I got a big taste there. When I tipped it over, it came rolling down. Wasn't ready for that. A lot more intensity on the nose on this one. And I don't know, studies probably say that the aromas of food or beverage are a big portion of the flavor. But certainly this one has a lot more nose to it. Now let's go to these guys. So this is the Liberté, which is, I guess, a versatile glass. Love the tulip shape. It's got a little bow in there. Very similar to the machine Gabriel glass. Let's see. Actually getting more nose out of the 1855 model. This guy, I kind of like the feel of this one in my hands more. Gotta be a little careful, I can splash it out of there if I'm not paying attention. Terrific. So I guess the bottom line is that love these glasses. I drank beer out of them last night. They were fantastic for that. And love the nimbleness of the glass. Love the wide base. I guess maybe the diameter of the rim would be an issue for some people. I have no problem with it. Probably great for champagne. I don't like drinking champagne out of flutes, so this is probably a great champagne glass. So that's it. That's my review. Thanks a lot, Chris, for the gift, and good luck, and see everybody on Berserker Day. Thank you. Bye-bye.